We have to be competitive with other countries. When we're paying 2 points more than Germany, or we're paying more than other countries, we should be paying less than everybody else. We have the dollar. We have the strength. We have the greatest country on earth. We should be paying less. So the Fed rate is too high. It's very simple. It's too high. It puts us at a competitive disadvantage, especially when it comes to exporting our product to other countries. The other countries love that. I don't like it at all.
Leave it to Trump to be Donald Trump. I don't know what lower interest rate environments truly mean for the overall economy and the stock markets. I'm not going to comment on it, but I love sharing the news with you guys. And before I break down my short-term financial goals for the next 2 to 3 years with my six-figure stock portfolio, along with my other passive income sources, I wanted to update you guys on the crazy news that happened yesterday when the Robinhood app crashed. I didn't realize the severity of how many people this was truly going to affect, considering there's more than 3 million plus users on the platform, and somehow I think it's a lot more than that. But you guys definitely let me know in that comment section about how you were being affected, and I just want to touch base on some of this because I think it's kind of important. A bird that knows what's good said, "Unfortunately, I trade with Robinhood. Was planning to snag 80 more shares of GEO at $14.90 during open. Locked out of some monster gains all day. Would have ended up with a near 13% return today. Pretty pissed, frankly. GEO is one of my favorite holdings. And yes, you could have bought any stock yesterday and have made decent returns. It was one of the greatest performing days in stock market history during these volatile times. And a lot of you were excited to buy stocks. And then I can't imagine what it would have been like opening up your account and having completely locked access to it. Taking a look, we got Mint Mark says, still can't log on, pissed. They will lose tons of users. I think they're going to get hit pretty hard here. And I think it's kind of hilarious to point out the fact that Robinhood was pretty much the platform that caused every major company that deals with trading like Goldman Sachs to basically giddy on up and do commission-free trades, only to have them screw this up on one of the most historical days in stock market history when people couldn't access their accounts. And I think that's going to really put a dent on the Robinhood name. It would be really fun to see how many users they're using. It'd be really fun to get an interview with some of the technicians and hear what they had to say about it. But somehow I think they're going to keep most of this under wraps until they get it resolved, and they're going to try and sweep it under the rug as fast as humanly possible. But what an ironic set of circumstances to be the leader in the trading app platform, to have something like this happen is not that great. But you guys can go check this video out, read some of the comments. I can't say thanks enough. You guys really give me some insight, and I'm glad that this community is super awesome. But what I'd like to do for you now is what I always say, is you got to write down your personal goals, and I want to share with you where I plan on being in the next 2 years of my financial independence retire early journey. So ladies, gentlemen, I look so forward to breaking this down for you. So let's jump right into this.
Drop it.
Welcome back, my passive income investors alike, to the most important thing you will ever do, which is just taking the first step to financial independence, is actually writing it down to see where you're going, where you're going to be, and are you on track for your personal goals. I actually go so far out of my way to put all of this on a whiteboard next to my bed that I wake up to every single day to see what is going on. Am I continuing to perform? Am I growing, or am I like slowing down year over year? But what we're going to do first is take a look at the stock portfolio, my short-term 2 to 3 year plan, and then we're going to take a look at some of the other passive income sources. As of right now, in this very moment, my stock portfolio is worth about $107,000, $108,000 USD. I am a Canadian citizen, so this all eventually gets converted to CAD, and the portfolio is worth around $140,000 Canadian, making me about 5,600 Canadian in dividends yearly, which is pretty decent because that's right around that 5% mark where I would like to see it. But my personal short-term goals, by adding about 500 a month using a compound calculator, I can show you exactly where I plan on being in the next 2 to 3 years with this portfolio. But the current principle, presuming we're at 140,000 CAD, if I don't screw this up, with annual additions at 500 a month, personally is about 6,000 a year. Now, this is where some discrepancies are going to come into play, but let's just take a look at a 2 year performance at market average returns of, let's just say, 10% to keep it even here. I'd be sitting at about $183,260. That's on a 2 year term, but we're looking about a 2 to 3 year term. So I should be left with between 180 and 200,000. Now, that is my minimum goal in the next 2 to 3 years. But if I can continue getting my average rate of return, which is roughly 20%, and everything stays the same over a 2 year time horizon, we'd be looking well over that $200,000 mark. What I would like to see happen, which is why I keep telling you guys, I focus on one of two ways of investing, which is growth, which is where I get my Apple, Facebook, Microsoft, Tesla. Those are my real growth stocks that I plan on holding for the next 2 to 3 years. And then I like high dividend yield. So I focus on anything that can pay me a reliable 5% plus yield. So these are like my banks. This is like my GEO group we were just talking about. This is like my utilities. And what I like doing is taking those high yields and then reinvesting them to get a faster pace growth. And then I also like my growth positions growing at a faster pace than my dividend stocks. So hopefully in the next 2 years, we'll get over that 200K mark. And then I can rediverse into mostly dividend stocks, which the main goal overall is to get it to the point where I'm making about $800 to $1,000 a month. And if I can get 200 plus thousand invested in the next 2 to 3 years at 5%, we'd be easily looking at about 10 to 12,000 a year in annual dividends. That is my short-term goal with this. Now, whether I achieve it or not, you're going to have to stick around and subscribe to find out, and also slap a like. This is a lot of personal information I'm sharing with you guys. Now, taking a look at some of the other aspects of my income that I plan on growing, starting with the YouTube channel here, guys. Now, obviously, it's really hard to gauge out what could happen long-term with Google, because there's nothing saying that all of this couldn't come crashing down in a year, and nobody's making ad revenue anymore, and Google kind of cuts all of this off. But I am really, really hoping that at some point in the next 2 to 3 years, I can get this YouTube channel to a level where I'm making about $500 to $1,000 a month. And I'm giving myself a very long time horizon with this. I'm not trying to be greedy, because I personally really enjoy making these videos, and I'm hoping it can become a sustainable source of income. Because if I can get $500 to $1,000 a month coming off my YouTube channel, and then I can get another $1,000 a month coming off my dividends, I mean, that'll bring me in a pretty healthy chunk of income to pretty much guarantee my rent payments and at least put some food on the table. I mean, it's not a luxurious life. It's not as luxurious living whatsoever. I mean, I'm not trying to joke with you guys here. I'm trying to be as realistic as possible. I mean, that would be a very healthy side income for me, and relatively passive income on top of that. And then if I include my personal working income, which is very gaugeant depending on the years, but I usually make about 20 to 30,000 a year off my personal income. I mean, that would put me in a very healthy position to not only, you know, live a fairly comfortable life, but also give me the opportunity to continue pushing some capital into the portfolio and continue growing it to the point where hopefully by the time I'm 35 to 40 years old, I will hit that FIRE state, the financial independence retired early journey, because I really only need to be making My long-term goals here with my stock portfolio is hopefully by the time I'm 35, I'll be sitting on somewhere between $400,000 and $500,000. And at that point, I should be able to make about $20,000 to $25,000 a year off my stock portfolio. Again, being within reason here, that isn't a luxurious living, but it's like not, like, I don't want to say guaranteed income, but it's a reliable income coming from multiple different places that guarantees a roof over my head and food on the table, because that is goal number one. I'm not looking to buy Lambos here, guys. I just want to know that if I don't have a lot of working income coming in, that I can rely on this to make sure I'm not going to be homeless, because I am more scared about being homeless and not being able to eat than I am worried about buying a new car or Ferrari, or, you know, going on a crazy luxurious trip like you maybe see your favorite Grant Cardone video or your Gary Vee videos. I mean, I'm not looking in that aspect of it. But ideally, in the short term here, guys, I just want to get myself in a position where I can actually move out of where I'm currently living, because my living standards right now are well below where I would like them to be. I mean, overall, guys, you don't want to be living at home with your parents. You don't want to be listening to somebody like Dave Ramsey reaming you out on a regular basis. Not that I ever call into him, but I know he'd be reaming me out if I ever called in, living at home, you know, saving and being as frugal as humanly possible. But in the current conditions I live in, I feel like it's going to set me up to really project later into my life. So I'm going to continue living frugally as possible, at least for the next 2 to 3 years. And then when I finally plan on moving out and going to rent somewhere, that, you know, all this income that I put so much time and effort into is going to help keep growing itself, whether I just put my working income toward my living expenses and use my passive income to keep growing itself into that snowball effect. I'll have at least some options. And I'm glad that I started this when I was 23 years old. I'm going to be 28 this year, and I do not want to be living at home by by the time I'm 30. I mean, I do not want to hit 30 and still be living with my parents. I know people that are 30 living with their parents, but it's not one of my personal ambitions to be financially free, basically relying off my parents here. But mind you, you do what you got to do, guys, and this is just what I'm doing to get ahead. Now, aside from the YouTube and the stock portfolio, I am working on a bunch of other stuff. If you know, I'm obviously running the Shopify store for the chartmaster.com. We plan on starting another two websites this year and perhaps even purchasing one. I really want to grow a nice portfolio of functionable online businesses that can help generate some good, decent, it's more or less active income. It kind of becomes passive, but like YouTube, there's a lot of upfront work and you got a lot of know-how. You got to learn a lot. I've been putting years into this stuff to finally get somewhere with it, but I'm really, really hoping that I can generate 500 to 1,000 a month off websites, 500 to 1,000 a month off my YouTube channel, and somewhere between 800 to 1,000 a month off my stock portfolio, bringing me in a total of somewhere between 2 and 3,000 a month just off those few income sources, discluding my working income. Many of you know I'm a full-time magician. I don't want to focus on that to be reliant because it's very volatile being a performer. I do, like I said, on average make between 20 and 30K a year, but I want to make sure that's kind of fun to me. I enjoy doing my job and I don't want to do my job because I have to get paid. And I know that might sound a little stingy to some people out there that are forced to work jobs they don't like. But like I said, guys, I've been very frugal, very diligent over the last 5 years to put myself in a position where I can actually enjoy my working life without having to be 100% reliant on the income and make kind of decisions based off that. I want to be able to do what I love because I love it, not because I have to do it. And I'd love to know what you guys think about all of this in that comment section below. What are your passion projects? What are you working on to build up your snowball effect and getting you to your personal short-term goals? I'd love to hear from you. You guys make all of this possible, so stay cool, stay awesome, and I look super forward to chatting to you tomorrow.